Ladies and gentlemen, Tankers of Blitzverse to the channel! A great recipe today for a premium tank in World of Tanks Blitz. Let's give it tracks, left and right, some wide tracks as well with big road wheels, give it a good mobility about, let's say, top speed 40 km per hour? Yeah, let's do it 40 km per hour. Let's give it a little bit of angling on the side and some spaced armor. Give it a gun, which is derpy, which has a long aim time, which is bad accuracy, and has about 400 alpha per shot. Let's keep the hatches quite small, fit a well-armored, rounded, inverted, frying pan-shaped turret on top of it, and then give it, well, more or less the same statistics as an IS-6, an Object 252U, an IS-5, an IS-3 Defender, except not without an autoloader, because it may look too much like an IS-3 Defender if it has an autoloader. Let's give it a single shotgun, and then make it look like a WZ-112-2, or like a 112 Glacial, or like a WZ-110, and then we'll call it a WZ-111. And then we can sell it, because that's what people want. Welcome for a very long, ranty intro about the WZ-111. And this one is, of course, currently available in World of Tanks Blitz as part of Black Friday. And it will cost you 5,000 gold, you will get 20 coupons, which means that you will get half a M4FL10 as well. At least you get the coupons and then you have to trade them in, so the FL10 is not quite free. But you can see that this tank is... this is a bouncy tank. It's a typical Russian slash Chinese tank with a derpy gun. And those two ISs, tier 7 ISs, are just sort of running around and they are bouncing on the front because this tank has a pike nose. And it's got APCR for standard ammunition and heat, and they've got AP and APCR, so that won't work. And then you're getting shot upon by that AMX-1357, who has a fast bouncing gun. That one has a machine gun, obviously, at 90 alpha per shot. And that's a great flanking machine, but one versus one against the WZ-112, that is not going to work. In the meantime, the chat is comedy gold. I still think chat would be best to be completely removed because of all the toxicity, but when you get stuff like this, it can be fun. It can be fun in a way. But as said, this tank, it is available currently in the World of Tanks Blitz store. And Bogen Flugel sent me this one. He said, well, it's me trying to have you like a boss, and it kind of worked. Yeah, because, let's face it, I've cut out part of the beginning of the video, and that wasn't too spectacular. It was just him trying to get some shots on Port Bay, playing very cautiously. He does pull off a Kolobanov and gets a steel wall, but that's mostly because of that that's an AMX-1357 shooting at him. And that counts towards... the shots being fired at you, and the potential damage is higher than that 90, I think. But yeah, he played well, got a nice first class medal. But the beginning of the game wasn't that brilliant. And this tank is, as said, a proper heavy. It's big, it's cumbersome, it's typically Chinese slash Russian. There will be people yelling at me because I say it's typically Chinese slash Russian, but let's face it, it's copy paste more or less. You have a very good frontal turret armor. Make no mistake about that. That's 325 to 30 nominal, but it's rounded. It creates control bounces. The gun mantlet is monstrous. You have some hatches on top at 150 mils only, and these can be weak spots. But yeah, a Tiger 2 at 310, it will struggle against your front because you have a pike nose with a very weak lower plate, and there's really no angling you can do to get that towards an autobounce. But use the gun depression of the tank, which, as comes with all the tier 8 Chinese slash Russian heavy tanks, it is not brilliant at all. Only 5 degrees. But VVK is doing his level best here to not die, and he is not going to die because his Pantera is all too trigger happy, and he's on a reload and he bounces. Nice one. Nice one. And yeah, he's going to get a first class medal as well. 3,217 damage dealt, 1,175 blocked. And that block damage mostly comes from having the tank wiggling around. It's got a truckload of spaced armor all around, and that's what makes the armor work. Pretty much the whole side is lined with spaced armor, except behind the tracks, and there the armor is only 80 mils. But when you get a spaced armor, when people shoot at you and they try to shoot heat, that will catch on the spaced armor. It's 30 mils of space and 80 on the armor itself. So that allows you to side scrape very, very effectively. And in that regard, this tank can really hold the line. If you can go hold down and not be in a position where you have to use the gun depression. I mean, people tend to overthink hold down. They think that being hold down means you go towards that spot right in the middle on B, peek over the ridge, and then try to shoot. But hold down is just one thing. Is hiding your hull. Your hull has to be down. This AMX, God bless it. What are you thinking, buddy? Oh, look at that. That's an LTTB. He's completely isolated. He's not. Yes, you are on AMX 1390, but dude, it just doesn't work like that. That's a WZ-110. Yes, he manages to get away. We've got Boog and Flugel in the first game. We've had a VVK in the second game. And this is Lieutenant Hawk. Not Light Tank Hawk or, I don't know, Lawrence Tripburn Hawk, but that's nasty. Lycan blocks him. He gets shot. I think he would have been able to pull behind that little bit of topography and then hide, but yeah, when the T-34 shoots you and then does this. Oh, I'm dead again. I poked out and now I'm dead. It just happened again. Yeah, it just happened again. Should have stayed behind that pillar. That would have been a lot better. As said, the WZ-111 is not about DPM. DPM is actually quite bad. Even for tier 8 heavies, it's 15 out of 29 total. Tier 8 heavies, 2036. And you're going down to 1731 if you're using the heat shells. And that's actually with a rammer. So then you have to be thankful for people like this T-34 who would decide to go just push in and then just as you bouncing on the Lycan. That's a bad trade, buddy. Why did you push in like that? When T-34-1 had died, you can't run away from both a Lycan and a WZ-111. Then he bounces as well, getting shot in the back. Bye-bye. And there was a Lycan who bounced, and the SU managed to penetrate. And Lieutenant and the Lycan are up against a WZ-110 and a P-40 Theta and a Tiger P who is unspotted at the moment. And the Lycan decides to go around. The Lieutenant warns him, mate, don't do it. Whoa, Watty, wait a little bit. I'm coming with my big gun and my long reload. You just have to wait it out a little bit. And if you're top tier, this is a great scenario. If you're bottom tier, well, let's say not so much, because then you really are low on the DPM side. Then again, stuff like this happens. What was the guy doing? Well, he's dead now. Right, 2 versus 1, but that's a, full health Tiger P. Not a full health one, but pretty much full health. And a Tiger P who seems to know what he's doing. He shoots the Lycan. He does not go in to shoot the Lieutenant. Damn phone call! Oh, that calls for a sip. Oh. Brilliant, yeah, GG, mate, but you have to carry this home first. APCR, he's firing APCR, that's a standard ammo, Bulldog, but thanks for the encouragement. I take the hit from the Tiger. One through the low plate. There we go. Come on, like it. Can you finish him off? Ah, that's annoying. One versus one. Both of the tanks are one shots to each other now. And that means that Lieutenant has to go side scraping. But this Tiger P knows what he's doing. He's side scraping as well. You can see that with APCR, even with the heat, we can't really see how that side plate is looking. But that he would probably bounce as well. And the Tiger is backing off, ready to fire, but so is Lieutenant, and he's letting the Tiger back away just a little bit more, and then there we go, APCR right through the cupola on top. Well played there, 5,208 damage? Yeah, no, 5,200 damage. Nice credits as well, with a standard account, not even a premium account, so go figure what you can earn with this tank if it is a if you're running a premium account, but he does have the boosters, which does help a lot. And that's it for today, ladies and gentlemen, tankers of this universe. I'll catch you all in the next video. Cheers and happy tanking!